The differences between segments and groups are sometimes a little difficult to understand. That's why I'll be repeating some of the concepts here again and again. In general, segments are like filters or conditions that you actually set up, and then depending on your subscribers and whether they meet those conditions, they will be put or taken out of that specific segment automatically and instantaneously. So this happens, it's like set and forget. Now with groups, it's a little different. It depends on how you tag those subscribers and what group you tag them with. So for example, you can have cat lovers. And if you have a cat lovers page, if people join your form and you connect that form to a group that is called cat lovers, they will be tagged with that group every time they join through that specific form. If you import your subscribers, you can also tag them with groups. This usually happens manually, and you can use groups with automations and forms and campaigns, whereas segments are dedicated mostly to campaigns. But with segments, you can really dial into that subscriber and send him whatever and exactly what they want. All right, so let's look into this, how this actually happens. Let's dive right in. To see the difference between segments and groups, let's go to subscribers and let's click segments. And here I've created different types of segments. I'm going to go ahead and click this one that is called inactive students. And here is what is set for the inactive students. We have type, time inactive, have not opened or clicked any emails for the last 90 days, and they belong to a group that is called students. So all these people belong to the students group, and also they have not been active, which means they haven't opened any emails or clicked any emails for the last 90 days. Now this is a dynamic segment, and that means that if someone doesn't meet these conditions, they instantly get taken out of this segment. And if someone else, some other subscriber, meets these conditions, they will be automatically put into this segment. So for example, let's go ahead and click one of these subscribers and let's edit the details of the subscriber and let's take him or her out of this group. Here we have students, we're going to click the X. So we'll take the person out of the group, save changes. So we had 9 people in that segment before. Now let's just go ahead and go back to subscribers here and let's go to that segment, which is here and inactive. And we can already see there are 8 subscribers here. And if we go into the segment, we see that in fact, that subscriber isn't here anymore. And of course, we can add more filters and have a different name for this segment. To create a new segment, we can go to segments here. And whilst in the segments tab, we click create segment, or we can also just go ahead and click all subscribers, create some kind of filter. For example, we can choose the active subscribers. Then we can choose type. For example, fields, we can use the country field. Then we can choose an operator. Let's say is set. So if someone has their country field set, we will see them here. And we see 13 subscribers that have their country field set. And we can now create a segment by clicking save as segment. We give the segment a name. For example, subscribers with country data, and click create. And there we go. These are these subscribers. This is what they are filtered through, or these are the conditions that need to be met. And now if we go to segments, we will see this. Subscribers with country data, and we have 13 subscribers like this. And now that we created this segment, we will be able to use the segment when creating campaigns. Now with groups, it's a little different. For example, I have a dog lovers group, book clubs group, and you can create a new group by just clicking create group. Let's say cat lovers. And groups are basically tags. So when you import subscribers, you can tag the specific subscribers with groups. Also, when you use automation or you use forms, you can connect the forms or automations to specific groups. So when people join groups, they can get a specific automation. Or when they join forms on your website, they can be tagged with these groups that you have created here. With segments, things happen automatically, depending on whether the specific people in the group meet the specific conditions that are set by you in the specific segment. With groups, you can add people manually or remove the people. For example, I can click a couple of subscribers, click this action button, and click remove from group. Or I could add these people to other groups. Another way is what I already showed you with segments, is you click on the specific person, click edit, and add the person to a group here, for example, cat lovers, or remove the person by using this little X over here. So again, these are like tags, groups are like tags, and segments. Let's go back to subscribers, click a segment, and let's view the segment. And segments are basically a set of conditions that need to be met in order for the subscribers to be in that specific segment. And one more time, segments are used within campaigns. Groups can be used in campaigns, forms, and automations. If you need more information about segments or groups, please watch the dedicated videos. Thanks for watching. Have a wonderful day, and I will see you in the next video. Again, thank you for watching. If you need more help, contact us directly or join our academy and learn all the ins and outs of MailerLite. All the details are in the description. See you there and have a wonderful day.